Hello friends, hi YouTubers. So after a long time I'm making this video. So again, some good topic where you know you will find it interesting. So what I want to show you is, you know, if do you like this kind of aquarium, this planted one, all greenery and all. So it's actually very good for the fishes also, because you know it absorbs the nitrogen, nitrates, and it also is a good hiding space for the fishes, and they like it. So you, if you have guppies, you have mollies, you have zebras, you have angels, you have some algae eating fishes, like this one hiding behind the rock, and some tetra fishes. So it's good for them overall, because you know they like it very much to hide in them, and also it's very soothing for them to live in there. So I have some guppies moving here behind the angel. There are some loaches, one kissing gourami, and some double tail mollies, zebras, guppies. So that one there, the pink guppy, actually thinks it's a zebra, so it just moves with the zebra. It doesn't mix up with the other guppies. Not secondary, yeah, that's one on the top. So do you actually want this kind of green aquarium with plants which is very good for the fishes? Yes, so please subscribe to my channel. Also click on the bell icon and give a thumbs up for this video, so that I can make more such informative videos for you. Okay, so keep watching till the end. You will find out how you can have this greenery. So one hint I would like to give you is, you know, this all plant just came from one single stem, one plant, and I had, and it is now, you know, whole bunch of plants in the aquarium now. So keep watching, I'll show you how you can make it and what you need for this kind of aquarium. Also, one more thing, do you see this molly babies? I have so many of them. So they are in a separate container kind of thing for molly or guppy babies. So this is all because of this plant. So I am going to show you this plants which are there with the babies. I'll plant them and show you how you can have them grow, and from one plant how you can multiply them into so many plants. So this is this plant is actually Indian swamp weed. It's actually kind of weird, but it's very good for the fishes, because they give them a whole ecosystem, and it's very nice for them. So this all guppies, if you can see, very small, few days old babies to a month old baby, so all they are growing fine. So I'll keep watching, I'll show you how to get them, you know, these plants. So it's a very quick, simple DIY thing which you can use and have a green planted aquarium. No need of carbon dioxide, not so much expenses, and it's very DIY cheap way of getting a planted aquarium. So all you need is this kind of plastic bottles, waste plastic bottles that you don't use, one pair of scissors. So I've cut some bottles, so you know, this half bottles, so you cut them somewhere, you know, here, and so that there is ample space for the plant to grow. So I'll just cut this and come back. So friends, what I've done is, you know, fill this halfway up with some substrate, some not substrate, actually it's dirt mixed with some fertilizers. You should have some fertilizer, because the plant needs some fertilizer, because only in, you know, if you have dirt, it will not be very good for the plants to grow. So if you look at this plant, the back one, this has some shortage of fertilizer, so the leaves you see are growing yellowish, and they are a bit curly towards the edges, so that means that it is not having enough fertilizers. So I recently just changed its soil so that, you know, it gets more fertilizers and it will grow, start growing. So hopefully soon, in few days, you'll see good growth on that. And these are all its babies. This is the main mother plant and all of these are its babies. So what I do is I'll take some of the plants from these babies. Yeah, they're all scared now. So yeah, I got one plant. See this plant? So I can make actually two plants, but I'm not doing that because, you know, it has one plant growing this side and another can grow from here, but I'm not taking that risk. I'll just use it as one plant. You can see this leaf, this, why it's called a weed? Yes, the reason for that. See, this is a broken leaf. This is a broken leaf. I don't know if it is focusing properly or not, but this is a broken leaf and the leaf is growing some, you know, roots. So you can have one new plant from if you have a broken leaf also. So, but that it takes time to grow back, to grow to that size. We have proper cuttings, it is faster way to grow. So I'll just plant this leaf as well. So what you have to just do is just press the roots inside. Okay, I'll plant this other plant also. So I have four of these things, so I'll plant more. I have quite a lot of plants. If you see, I have cuttings, so I'll use all those cuttings. This one I can take now. So it has good root formation within a few days. I had just broken it from the main plant and just kept it with the babies. So I'll plant it with this other plant, the leaf one. So leaf is also going to grow. Okay, I'll just put it. Maybe I would need some more soil in that because it's too deep for the plant. I'll grow it here. That one is too deep. So I'll just put some more soil in that. And so I'm putting a bit of more soil here. Okay, some more, some here, some in the other plants. Here. So don't just actually fill it up till top because you need some space for putting some gravel. So why you need gravel? Because, you know, this all dirt can come out and it will be floating in your tank. So better have some gravel on it so that it's covered and doesn't come out. So I'll just quickly fill this all pots. So you see here, I've put all the plants into the soil, and now what I'll do is I'll just take some gravel from the aquarium and put it in on these plants to cover the soil. Here, so here, put some soil. Just fully cover it so that all the dirt doesn't come out, and you actually put it in the tank. So here I'm grabbing some gravel, some more here, some here. So one more thing, you should, if you have fishes like goldfish, koi, or some bigger fishes like, you know, cichlids, don't do this because, you know, they'll just destroy all your plants and, you know, it will be all a waste. So because I have all the small fishes which, you know, like to live in plants, I'm doing this. So you see, friends, I've covered up all of them in the gravel, so now the soil won't come out when I actually plant them inside. I'm just now going to plant them in the aquarium. See how slowly we have to do it, because, you know, if you just dump it into the tank, all you know, things can come out and dirty your tank. So you have to do it slowly. Here, very gently let the water come in into the plant. Let it fill with water slowly. still some air bubbles will come out, some soil will come out, but not much. You just drop it down very gently. You can see the difference between the new plant and the old ones. So it will take some few days, maybe 10-15 days, and then it will actually grow into a very beautiful plant. So hope you like this. It is a very good idea when you have an aquarium and you don't want to put an extra expenses in, you know, don't want to put extra expenses for plants, don't want to do CO2 part, and you know, if you buy substrate with, you know, for plants which is you have to lay down, it makes the aquarium messy, very messy. So with this way, you can also change the soil very easily, and you can have a very good planted aquarium. So we can hide this plastic half bottles into the gravel like this one, which is almost hidden, so you won't be able to make out if it's a bottle so easily. And see how the fishes love moving around it. So hope you like this video. Please give a thumbs up if you like the video. Do subscribe to my channel and please hit the bell icon so that you get latest updates for my new videos. Thanks, have a good day.